Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up RLS when you have two fact tables connected to one dimension and you only want RLS to affect one of those fact tables. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Two fact tables, one dimension. RLS. How do I set up RLS to only affect one of those fact tables? This question has come up in some of the comments below in some of our videos, and I decided to do a video on it. Before I get into this, big shout out to Phil C. Mark. Thanks, Phil, for spending about an hour or so with me chatting about this and helping me come up with the solution. Couldn't have done it without you. Much appreciated, my friend. That's what's great about this Power BI community. There's always someone out there willing to help. There's one solution that Phil and I talked about applying RLS to each individual fact. But if you have fact tables that are really wide with lots of columns and really high with lots of rows, it could adversely affect performance by implementing RLS on your fact tables. And I would completely avoid that if you can. So I'm not going to talk about that video, but I'm going to show you the steps that we took to get to the solution. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Let's say you have this model. I have this sales territory table. It filters the reseller sales and the internet sales. And I want to add RLS here. And I only want the RLS to be applied to reseller sales, not internet sales. So what can I do? Well, the first thing I do is go ahead and add the RLS. So I'm going to do that really quickly. I'm going to go to manage roles. I'm going to create, and I'm going to call it reseller. And then I'm going to go to my table right here. And I'm going to say add a filter on email address. And I'm going to provide user principal name. Always check to make sure everything is done and click save. And if I go and view as role right now, it's going to be applied to both because of my filter directions. And when this came up on the live stream, people were like, well, just make one relationship inactive so it won't apply to both. So let me show you what happens when you do that. So if I go here, double click this guy and just say, make it inactive. Click OK. I'm going to go over to my report. And the first thing you'll see is that, it's not filtering anymore. The slice will work, but the value doesn't change. That's the first side effect of the inactive relationship. And then if I go here and say, let's view this as role, I have access to only the United States, and Adam has all the international customers from reseller because I want to filter reseller and not internet sales. So we click OK. And what you'll see, my slicer only contains United States. What about the other ones? Because I want to filter internet sales, not reseller sales really, but internet sales should be filtered by the others. I can't do that using inactive relationship because that single table RLS is applied to it and it's going to filter it out. So what do I do? Then I had another idea. So I did a video on this one called role playing dimensions. Let me show you. Let's stop viewing. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to delete this relationship. So basically I'm going to have two dimensions and they're going to play two different roles. This is going to be my reseller sales territory, and I have an internet sales territory table, and I'm going to create a relationship here. So basically I have two sales territory tables, one for reseller sales and one for internet sales. If I go here and I click this one, it's still doing the same thing. So I need to tidy up a bit. So I'm going to move this one over here because this applies to the reseller sales. And then I need this country to come from my internet sales territory table. And then I need to create a new slicer and add my country from my internet sales. So now I have two different tables, but now it only affects this table, which is great. And then if I do this one, it only affects that table. This is pretty good. And then if I go and do view as role, use myself, click OK. And now what you're going to see, the RLS is applied to my reseller sales and it's filtered. But then on my internet sales side, I see everything. If I multi-select, it shows everything and it doesn't affect that. The challenge with this one is you have to maintain both of those tables. Consistency, you change one thing in the other, you got to change it in the other, keep them synced up. If I wanted to correlate internet sales and reseller sales on the exact same visual element, I can't because their attributes for sales territory come from two different tables, and I can't put those country and country from both of those tables on the same axis. It's impossible. This is where Phil and I, we got to this point. He was like, Patrick, let's try something. Let me stop viewing. So we're going to delete this, take country from here. I'm going to use country from the internet sales table because there's no row level security. And now as I select, you'll see how everything filters. Now this value doesn't work. We'll fix that with our relationship. So let's head over to our model view. So we're going to take this sales territory from our internet sales that doesn't have any RLS. We're going to drag it right here. Boom. So now let's revisit the report. Everything's working. This is great. Let's go back over here because we need to implement the RLS. So what I'm going to do is I made a smaller version of this table with only the columns I need. In my case, I only need a column to establish the relationship to the table that requires RLS and the email address or whatever column you're going to need to do your dynamic RLS. And then I hit that table. So I'm going to hide this table and I'm going to hide this one because I don't need this one anymore. I could delete this one from the model actually. And then what I'm going to do is go to manage roles. I'm going to go here. I'm going to copy this expression because I'm going to reuse this. I'm going to clear this out and then I'm going to go to this guy and just add that expression, check it, make sure it works and click save. So now I'm going to go over here back to my report. Everything's working. Let's clear everything out. The reason this is working is because if you go back to the diagram view or the model view, you see I have a relationship to both of these with no RLS applied. So this will filter both of these. This one with the RLS applied will filter this one. And you're probably thinking, well, what about the complete list? I still need that complete list when we apply RLS. Well, it's going to work because of my internet sales territory or whatever you want to call it. It does not have any RLS. Let me show you. So let's go back over here. Let's do view as role, other user. See if I can spell my name right. Click OK. Oh, United States. That's what's supposed to happen. Choose Australia. Nothing's there. Choose United States. There we go. United Kingdom only on this side. Okay. So what if we switch it to Adam? Let's go over here. Let's change this to A. Saxton. Over here on this side, United States should disappear and only countries that Adam has access to. I'm going to click OK. Australia and the United Kingdom. If I choose Canada, the United States selected is not going to show there. I can unselect it. Still doesn't show there. So this appeared to be the most elegant approach. You still need to maintain a separate table, but a smaller table. It's not an exact duplicate. In my case, it was just the email address and the key to establish that relationship. Role level security is supplied to one table. In my case, the reseller sales and not internet sales where I don't want it applied. All right. What do you guys think? Any questions? Any comments? Have you ran across this before? Have you solved this a different way? You tried this solution and you're stuck on something? I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.